Hello. I'm Norbert Gleich, MD, and I'm the medical director and chief scientist here at the Center for Human Reproduction. I would like to address today a problem that we very frequently are asked about, and that is the early miscarriage. Miscarriages or pregnancy loss can occur at any stage of pregnancy. When it happens very, very early before we can visualize a pregnancy on ultrasound, we call it a chemical pregnancy. And those are miscarriages, but they are so early that we do not consider them in pregnancy statistics. So when we or other fertility centers report their pregnancy rates in various patient populations, that usually should exclude those chemical pregnancies. But they're still pregnancies, and they have clinical meaning, because if you detect pregnancy hormone, HCG, in the blood of a female, and she didn't receive it as a medication, then that means that an embryo must have implanted, because only the embryo produces this HCG. And if this HCG is then found in the blood of the mother, the only way that that fetal product shows up in the blood of the mother is if an implantation has taken place. So for clinical purposes, this is a very important point, because it obviously is important to know whether a woman even can achieve an implantation or not. And there are studies in the literature from the early days of IVF where it was shown that women who go through, for example, a first IVF cycle and have a chemical pregnancy, once they go into a second IVF cycle, have better pregnancy chances than 100 women who in their first IVF cycle just had a negative pregnancy test. So there's importance to the chemical pregnancy diagnosis, even though we don't count it as a real pregnancy. We are talking about a clinical pregnancy once we can see an ultrasound. And that depends on the equipment and the skills of the operator of the ultrasound, but in principle, with currently available good ultrasound equipment, we should see pregnancies shortly after 5 weeks gestational age, which in terms of IVF cycle outcomes really means roughly 3 weeks post-transfer, because when we date pregnancies, we still are adhering to actually completely outdated habits of going back to the supposedly first day of last menstrual period, which obviously is about 2 weeks before an embryo transfer takes place in IVF. So an early pregnancy, an early clinical pregnancy, must be seen on ultrasound. And it is usually seen only as a round gestational sac. And then, depending on the age of the pregnancy, every week or so, we see more and more. So at 5 weeks, we will see a small gestational sac. By 6 weeks, we should already see a little fetal pole with the fetal heart beating. By 7 weeks, we should already see a good fetal representation, and obviously with continuous normal fetal heartbeat over 140 beats per minute. Yes, the fetal heart beats much quicker than our heart does. A normal fetal heart beats at over 140 beats per minute. So that's as a way of background. Now, at all of these stages, and even into the second trimester, a pregnancy can miscarry, and the causes can vary. It is in general assumed that the most frequent cause for early miscarriages are chromosomal abnormalities. And that is probably still true and correct, except that as we now are learning more about the genetics of early embryos, we have to kind of reinterpret what has been published over past decades. And the reason is very simple. All of our information about the causes of early miscarriages stem from pathological examinations of those miscarriages, meaning a woman has a miscarriage, there are what's called products of conception available, they are sent to pathology, they're looked at under the microscope, and more importantly, they are spread out, meaning we are taking a bunch of cells and testing their chromosomal makeup. Now, historically, that used to be done by culturing those cells for a few days and then doing what's called a spread. And that was a very reliable and successful method in determining whether those cells, or this bunch of cells, meaning that biopsy that we used from the products of conception, was chromosomally normal or not. Turns out that the data we have been generating for many, many decades in that way are really not completely correct. And the reasons are technical. Our pathology colleagues and our genetics colleagues always told us when we take tissue and send it to pathology, to take it from the placenta, from the placental part rather than the fetal part. And that's what we have been doing for decades. Except that now we know that there is a difference at times in the chromosomal makeup of the placenta and the fetus. The placenta is much more frequently showing chromosomal abnormality than the fetus. And therefore, now that we know that, we also have to understand that all the numbers we accumulated over the decades that told us that maybe up to 80% of early miscarriages are chromosomal in nature, they are probably, or likely, highly exaggerated. And that is important news, because more recent data using more modern genetic diagnostic tools suggest that the real rate is probably closer to only 50%, maybe even lower than that. And that has obvious meaning, because that means that a much larger part of early miscarriages than we used to believe, and that even textbooks till today are telling us, may have other causes than chromosomal abnormality. And that is obviously of very significant clinical importance, because in order to look for something, you have to know that there is a suspicion for something. So we used to be kind of lazy in the past about miscarriages. And when the miscarriage happened early on, we used to think, oh, it's chromosomal. No longer. It's at best 50-50, and maybe even less. So if you have a miscarriage, discuss with your obstetrician gynecologist or fertility specialist the possibility of testing your pregnancy, because it is clinically very important to know whether, when you lose a pregnancy, it was a chromosomally normal pregnancy or not. If it was a truly chromosomally abnormal pregnancy, then it's usually a random event and there's no big meaning to it. But if it turns out that your early pregnancy loss is chromosomally normal, a normal female or a normal male, then this really means that there is a different reason for the miscarriage. And it means that we really need to find out what that reason is if we want to prevent it from happening again. Thanks very much for listening.